fights, grapevines, humiliation, oppression, and tribalism rests on our shoulders, instigating violence and claiming innocent lives, hatred running in our veins and everyone fighting to stain the other at any cost.
I am worried about our future.
But why?
Cyber wars, corrupt assassinations, and undying conspiracies, turning our smooth and well-organized societies into violent and divisible environments.
Indeed worrying. If this is the baton we want to pass on to the next generation, then what will they actually become?
And our heroes and heroines are probably shaken in their graves because this is not what they actually fought for.
For the record, there is one important moment in the history of our noble land, the remarkable day when our celebrated heroes fought for independence to set us free from evils of slavery. The rich taste of its freedom and hospitality blended with devotion and admiration. That day, the Gambia has shown her smiling face to the rest of the globe.
Have we forgotten what has brought us together? One Gambian flag, red, white, blue, white, green, complemented by a national motto of progress, peace, and prosperity. The national anthem that warms the heart of every Gambian whenever it is sung.
One national pledge, which reads, "It is the combination of government and people working together in unison and harmony that still lead us to achieve the progress that we all desire. We must stand together as one people, with one goal, and move forward as one nation."
For if we insist on pushing our personal goals without keeping our collective objectives and responsibilities in mind, then indeed we shall be divided and divided. We shall fall. Let us renew those promises we made to ourselves and our country at the time of independence as enshrined in our national anthem.
We might have different opinions or even looking at things differently, but these are not against the laws of nature. We should embrace one another with dignity and respect, regardless of how we see things, where we come from, or even our ethno-linguistic background.
Those titles, money, or class differentiate us from the rest of the human race. There are people who have food but cannot eat. Others have money but are not in peace. Let's be humble to our fellows, because we can be on either side of the road, and probably by then, we will know that man is social being.
Imam Abdul Aziz Dabah once said, "Let's not turn the blessings which the Almighty gave us into weapons to fight our fellow mankind. Let's always live with peace and harmony and never adopt any alien habit which is not ours."
To our public servants, whenever we portray our trust in you, we entrust our inner safeties in your hands.
If I trust you and you trust them, then we have laid a foundation of love and a network of camaraderie upon which global peace can be propelled from. Let's not break the chain of trust, for each hook is as essential as the other.
The Mandinka,
the Fula,
the Wolof,
the Jala,
the Serel,
the Serahule,
the Manjago and the Agua all equal
on the beautiful land of the Gambia,
the smiling coast
of West Africa,
the children hub of BG Academy,
motivates and inspires
all generations.
Peace.